Hi, I'm Philip Arola, and this is PSAS's Nuc Challenge entry. This is just a quick demonstration to show that project's coming along on schedule. So here we got the main functions of the Nuc, how we're migrating our systems over. So here you'll see a web page that people can connect to, displaying sensor readouts from the rocket itself. I'll go ahead and nudge it, and you can see values wiggle around a little bit.
So this is what we call the 100-kilometer rocket. So it's liquid motor, carbon fiber, CubeSat control.
So I just rotated it a little bit, and you can see the roll rate change. And you can also see this commander interface, which is essentially our ground control system. So whenever we want to launch or check on certain subsystems of the rocket, you can look around this interface and turn Wi-Fi on, turn certain subsystems on, whatever you need to do to launch the rocket. And here is another piece of our control system. It also monitors a lot of the rocket subsystems. And here's a camera control system that we have here. Eventually, we plan to get this working on the Nuc too, so it can store video and also act as a, with the monitors we'll soon have with this. You can have a bunch of people, instead of having to watch from their phones or laptops, have like a big viewing party from the control center.
Where is the Nuc right now?
The Nuc is right here in this little mini server rack, little makeshift server rack. So it's running right here.
And what else is in there?
We have a network switch for all the network devices we'll have set up eventually. We'll definitely have more once we actually have a full ground control system set up. And we also have a, on a semi-related note, this is our ham radio. We use it to communicate across the ground because we like doing, going above and beyond simple walkie-talkies.
Awesome. And what is this, this thing?
This contraption is used to communicate with the rocket when it's moving in air. So it's like a shoulder-mounted rocket launcher from a video game. You point this thing at the rocket, and hopefully you have good aim so we don't lose communication with it. It operates on boosted Wi-Fi frequencies, so as long as you have a ham radio license, it's perfectly legal to do.
And what is it connecting, what is it talking to?
It communicates between our ground control network, well, one of them, and the rocket itself. So it basically acts as a giant bridge, like if you're to have a Wi-Fi mesh in a professional environment.
Okay, can we see the like launch tower and the avionics?
Absolutely. So, right now, this is our basic little simulation of
the rocket. Who the hell designed that board?
This is computational components of this system. So this is what I rotated earlier. It has the sensors inside of it, like accelerometers and gyroscopes.
And this is like in the rocket?
Yes, it's an internal component of the rocket. So this will be a version of this. We hope to get things condensed down so it's less spacious and less heated.
It's all open source.
Hot,
everything's
like, you know, heat is an issue always.
Yeah.
Okay. And it'll go
so
into
now we'll give you the tour of this guy.
It's actually not fully assembled anymore. this rocket.
And where does it go in here?
So
I know this is like half the rocket right now.
It's basically half assembled. So basically that we'll have like more sleeving over it for more structural protection. But it will go somewhere around here, and then you'll have stuff like this covering it. Then you'll have more leads to the nose cone.
Okay. Cool. And so what has the Nuc helped you do?
It's much, much more convenient than having to use a laptop and a wireless router. and a network switch, all, and then just wired together in a really ugly. I mean, it's wiring's always going to be ugly, but the less wires you have to do, the better, really.
So it's super compact and easy to use. And
yeah, the compactness is really helpful.
That's great. Okay, perfect. Anything else you want to say?
Not really.
Great.
Thank you.